Hi, John from The Spirited Gourmet here, and I wanted to talk about some of the other wines that we're going to be featuring this week. So it is the 4th of July weekend. We are celebrating our founding, or the establishment of our country. So I figured, let's do a lineup of all American wines to have. Why not? So let's get started. So we're starting off with Harmeyer's SRV Chenin Blanc. This is from the Subtle Ranch Vineyard in Clarksburg, California. This is all organic Chenin Blanc grown in the really sandy soils inside the vineyard. Really nice, kind of like fresh, has this nice kind of like light minerality to it, like white flowers, a little bit of honeysuckle, some orchard fruits. Really tasty, really delicious. Next, from Idlewild. This is a really cool producer that we've worked with in the past. This is their Flora and Fauna, the Bee. They make the Bird and the Bee. So this is a blend of Arnais, Muscat, and a tiny bit of Cortese. These are all Piedmont varietals. Idlewild works with all Piedmont grapes. This has this wonderful, like, beautiful acidity, this nice kind of like wet stone, river stone minerality to it. Has this nice kind of like white flower, jasmine, really kind of exotic quality to it, but really just an exceptional white wine for a hot summer day or for any time. Really outstanding with seafood as well. Next, from Eric Kent. Eric Kent is a producer out of Sonoma County. This is his Rosé, and this has been just absolutely stellar every single year that we've worked with it. It is a blend primarily of Pinot Noir blended with Grenache and Syrah to lend a little structure and spice. This is Rosé that is real wine. So you could certainly chill it, drink it in the backyard on a beautiful afternoon, and, you know, enjoy yourself. But this is also a wine that stands up to a really nice meal. Just has this wonderful sort of exotic quality of like strawberries and raspberries and watermelon. Absolutely delicious. I can't get enough of this stuff. Next, this one here with our friend The Babe on the label. This is a Pinot Noir from Wonderwall. 100% Edna Valley fruit. You get a little bit richer, a little bit spicier expression for Pinot Noir here. You get almost like a little bit of baking spice note on the finish that follows up the kind of like black cherry earthiness here. Really, really well made Pinot Noir from Andrew Jones. And last, kind of a personal favorite here. I've loved these wines for years. This is the Foxglove Zinfandel from the Varner Brothers. 100% Zinfandel. They don't use any oak here. It's something of a throwback Zinfandel. Before we all got used to these big, juicy, jammy Zinfandels that really sort of coat the palate, Zinfandel was much sort of fresher and brighter and had a much more sort of crisp quality to it. Put it in the fridge with a little bit of chill, have it with backyard barbecue, have it with cookout. It's really terrific. It's kind of a great reminder of just how delicious and refreshing Zinfandel can be. Well, I hope you get a chance to try some of these. I hope you all have a nice holiday weekend, and I hope we get to see you all in the shop very, very soon. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.